Hello, homeschoolers! Kamusta na po kayo dyan? Nako, ang tagal na nga po natin hindi nagkwentuhan, ang dami nangyari. But I know this is the season of, you know, making great decision for your homeschooling journey. Ang iHomeschoolph po ay gumawa ng magandang video na ito para sa guide nyo po, okay? For your future guide, so you can share it to others. So, in these videos or in this vlog, we're gonna discuss the advantages and disadvantages of homeschooling. Yay! O, diba? Kasi alam nyo, ang dami nagtatanong sa akin eh. Kaya sometimes, hindi ko na sila makausap lahat. So, ilalagay ko na sa video, o, diba? Okay, first up, for our first advantages of homeschooling, number one, learning never stops. Okay, learning never stops, definitely. Alam nyo, in all aspects, ang maganda po sa homeschooling, kontrolado nyo. And one way or another, when I say learning never stops, akala nyo yung mga bata lang ang pwedeng matuto? Kayo rin po ay matututo, okay? So you learn with your kids together. Someone was asking me nga, Nubi, paano yun? Ang tagal ko na, hindi ko alam paano ako magturo. Paano ito? Ayun nga you also learn in the process, okay? Not only that, you can also learn the real life aspect of life. It's not only mga academics, but real life skills ang pwede niyong matutunan. So, the first advantage, learning never stops. Number two, enjoying freedom. Ay, grabe, this is one of my favorite advantages of homeschooling. You know, it's so beautiful because you could be able to wake up every time, any time that you want. Not only that, you could be able to travel, okay? You could be able to enjoy. There's one time nga we were doing homeschool. And then, one of our dogs gave birth. And then what we did is we stopped and we went there and just watched my dog gave birth. So that freedom, it's really, really nice. Na hindi ko talaga makakompare sa ibang opportunities. That's why I really love homeschooling because I get to enjoy this freedom with my kids and with my husband as well. So, enjoying freedom. Number three, we have unlimited family bonding. Wow! Grabe lang kasi in a year, we could be able to plan our bonding without being scared kung mag-absent ba yung mga anak ko o hindi. O, diba? So, we could be able to cherish one another's birthdays, every event we could be able to go because we were able to plan and maximize our bonding. Not only that, we could be able to really venture and invest our time more on spending time with one another. Okay? Kasi we believe bonding, which is quality time, hindi lang yung bonding na basta ma-schedule mo lang, yun na yun. But it's gonna be like we schedule our playing, learning together, laughing together, as in unlimited family bonding. When you wake up until hanggang sa matulog ka, as in magsasawa kayo. But anyway, I'm just making a joke about nagsasawa. But eventually, this is one of the great decisions that we ever make because nowadays, so sobrang busy po, diba? Ako, I do not like to let my kids see me busy. Okay, and just being busy for the sake of being busy. I want my kids to have good memories of us being together and just spending time with one another. So, unlimited bonding, that's number three. Number four, strengthen our beliefs. You know, this is really important. I believe one of the things that we want to inject to our kids, my kids, is to really to know who they are and what they believe in. And that's really important to us. So, I know we have different families and we have different beliefs. This is your opportunity to be able to share that legacy to your kids. The belief system, the value system that you want to grow as a family. And one way or another, at the end of the day, my goal as a parent, now that I've been homeschooling for 14 years, my goal is my kids will be confident with what they believe and the values that they believe. Most importantly, is what they believe about God, okay? Their identity is with God and nothing else. So that's number four, strengthen your beliefs. Number five, delight in socialization. Ay, alam ko, very hot topic po ito. But you know, I believe, why did I say delight in this advantage? You know, first and foremost, I realized the most important socialization that your child should have is for you to have, to be as a parent to your child. Again, parent to child. I realized na pag confident po ang relationship ng bata sa kanilang parent, it's not so hard to be able to talk to other people. And what the good thing with homeschooling, hindi po siya nakabak sa isang age group lang po. Okay? Different types of people they will be able to encounter. And one time, or not one time, I think that this is my 7th year of homeschooling, people will come to my house once a week. Like 10 families go to my house, and with different types of age. And lola, lola, mother, father, age 0, age baby, until to 14-year-old, they will come to my house. Talagang right sa loob ng bahay namin. At ang maganda, yung mga anak ko, they'll be able to encounter this type of people, and they'll be able to learn how to, you know, take care of babies. And not only that, also talk to lolas and lolos, and also to mothers and fathers as well. So, do not be afraid when you talk about homeschooling. Actually, I think the best way of doing homeschooling and you want to improve socialization, you have to do homeschooling. It is an advantage and not a disadvantage. Number 6, good health. Ay, grabe, na-enjoy ko po to. Alam niyo po, na mga anak ko, bihira po silang magkasakit. Now, with all of this coronavirus and with all of the, you know, circumstances that is happening around us, na hindi tayo makalabas, diba, dahil sa coronavirus. And not only that, diba, nagkaroon pa tayo ng parang earthquake. So, natigil lahat. Natigil lahat ng mga school. So, yung mga bata, hindi makapag-pursue ng schooling because of that. And one way, there was one officer who texted me na, Novi, paano ba to? Gusto ko i-homeschool yung mga anak ko. Eh, nakatira sila sa Tagaytay. Sabi ko, yeah, I can help you. So, ang ganda lang ng homeschooling, hindi ka matitigil. And not only that, they can be protected and strengthen the immune system of your child. You know, I'm just really sad of some of my friends who were talking about na yung mga anak nila, gabing-gabi na umuwi, at pagdating pa, mag-aaral pa, at matutulog sila ng sobrang late dahil sa biyahe. So, yung time talaga, hindi mo siya mako-compress. And it's hard. So, ang nangyayari doon, yung immune system ng anak natin, nagkakaroon ng difficulty to adjust dahil nagkakaroon ng sipon at ubo. And not only that, pag klase siya, merong tendency na magkahawaan. So, homeschooling is one of the great ideas in times of like this. And it will really strengthen the immune system, not only your kids, but you as well. Number 7, identifying their passion. This is one of the great advantages. You know what? This will be the time that your child could be able to gauge what they really want to do. O, diba? Like, my daughter who is 3 years old, alam na niya na talagang gusto niya maging ballerina. Now that she's 14 years old, yun pa rin ang ginagawa niya. And she was still really consistent about it. And she really want to pursue it. That's why until now, hinuhomeschool ko pa rin siya. 14 years old na siya at nasa grade 8 siya. And she, alam niyo, grabe ha, she's like practicing 5 hours a day. Isipin niyo yun, kung hindi siya nag-homeschool, paano pa siya makakapasok sa regular school kung nagpa-practice siya ng 5 hours a day? Diba, ang hirap? And through that process, before she was able to really know na talagang yun ang gusto niya, talaga in-encourage namin siya, hinown namin siya, and we really help her to be able to spend more time with her passion in doing that. And that is dancing, and that is doing ballet. So, kung ano man interest or passion ng mga anak nyo, mas magkakaroon sila ng time to be able to discover themselves during homeschooling. Number 8, advantages is play, 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 play. Grabe! You know, this is one of the greatest part that I really like. Kasi, na-enjoy ng mga anak ko yung pagkabata nila. Okay? And not only that, I make sure with all the activities that we have, we always interject play. So, until now, alam nyo ba, na mga anak ko lahat ng teenagers, we still play at least once a week or twice a week. Kahit na sobrang busy sila, we take time to play. So that, alam nyo yun, kasi there are times na I still remember nung mga bata pa kami, sinasabi, huwag muna kayo maglaro, yung, kasi kailangan ko mag-aral. Eh sometimes parang, I just want to play and just do, you know, something for fun, for me to be distressed. But because of all the responsibilities of an institutionalized school, you have to do this, you have to do that, you have to do this extracurricular. So sometimes, nawawala yung fun. So sa homeschooling, we make sure that we need to play. Hindi lang para sa maliliit na bata. Kahit mga teenagers na, you still have fun. So in homeschooling, play is a must. Number 9, learning alongside with your children. O diba, alam nyo, ito yung lagi kong sinasabi sa mga homeschoolers na nag-asa akin, no, V, hindi naman ako expert. Hindi ko naman to magagawa, alam nyo. Then learn together. You just have to be honest with your kids. You don't have to be expert to teach them on that end. You just learn together with them and be honest about it in the process. And not only that, alam mo, ako, I didn't realize that I could be able to really love history. And then, when I was starting to do homeschool and I'm trying to research more about history books, grabe, I've never loved history like never before. And that's one of my favorite topics. So even though na matatanda na sila, na I know that they can independently do that in their own, I still teach history to them because I love it. And it really broadens my mind. And it also adds up to my learning and how to read my Bible, and also adds with history as well. So learn with them, and you might discover some of your giftings na hindi lang naman pagtuturo ng homeschool, diba? You can also develop yourself through this process of homeschooling. So learn with your kids as well. And number 10, I'm sure you like this, we can avoid traffic. O diba, grabe lang. Alam nyo, well, sad to say that we should pray for our government. We were forced to this kind of journey every day of our lives. And there's one time nga, dito near my school, no, nakatira sila sa Paranaque and they have to go here in Cainta because they really have chosen this school near beside us. Talaga nagta-travel siya mga 3 to 4 hours. So they have to wake up at around 3 a.m. or 4 a.m. just to go to that school. It's so hard. And I'm so blessed that my kids will not experience that as well. Didn't experience that as well. So traffic, what can you do in 3 hours? Ang dami mong pwedeng magawa. And you could be able to avoid that. If you think proximity is an issue, is a problem, well, homeschooling is one way. Makakatipid ka pa sa gas, makakatipid ka pa sa transportation. So, imbis na ilagay mo sa pamasahe yon, ilagay mo lang sa mga educational resources na alam mong pwede mag-develop sa mga anak mo. So, we can avoid traffic and you can be able to develop more of spending time with our family. And that is quality time with them. Okay, I hope that you did enjoyed our conversation or this blog about advantages of homeschooling. So if you have any questions, any inquiries, any violent reactions, na sana wala naman, okay? No, kidding aside, please share it with us so that we could be able to improve our blogs as well. And magtulungan tayo na mapo talaga ang goal ng ihomeschoolph. Okay, lagi lang po nating tatandaan, in homeschooling po, okay? Relationship is more important than academics. Ako po si Novi Antan, ang inyong homeschool coach, and I homeschool. Bye!